Come on, put your hand together. Come on.
I'm
Darlene D. Holmes.
And I'm Bishop Randall E. Holmes. And we want to welcome you to the New Hope MBC Ministries of Miami, where we believe in building strong families for the 21st century and beyond.
We welcome you to our live broadcast as we prepare to hear the word of the Lord. We invite you to join us in the praise and worship experience. Please invite a friend or two to come along as well.
Now, let's go right into the service.
Greetings. Welcome to New Hope MBC Ministries of Miami, where we believe in building strong families for the 21st century. Happy Sunday, and we are glad to be worshiping with you this morning. We serve an awesome God. We are so happy that we could be in the house of the Lord one more time. Let's just give God praise this morning. Let's lift God up this morning. Let's tell God thank you for letting us see another day. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, we just want to thank you this morning. We want to thank you for allowing us to wake up yet again, God, to give you praise. We want to thank you this morning for just letting us have a chance at this thing called life, Lord God. And God, as we go about life, God, we just ask that you forgive us, God, for our sins that we've committed, Lord God, against you and others, knowingly and unknowingly, Lord God. We ask that you navigate us, Lord God, so that we can go straight and not turn, Lord God, and that we can keep our eyes on you, Lord God. And God, we just want to thank you, Lord, for your son Jesus dying on the cross for our sins and for us to have a right to chance at life yet again. And we just want to give you all the praise, Lord, all the glory and all the honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Are y'all excited this morning? Are y'all ready to have church this morning? Are y'all excited this morning? I'm glad. I know the Bible said I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. And we're here right now. Even if you're serving in your home virtually, it doesn't matter. You're still in the house of the Lord. Let's give God praise this morning. Amen.
Hallelujah. Come on and bless God. Come on and give God praise right now, wherever you are. Come on, put those hands together for Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, he's worthy to be praised. Come on, we come to bless the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Put those hands together. Come on. Here we go. Come on. Come on, bless the Lord with me. Come on, bless the Lord with me. Come on, bless the Lord with me. Yeah. Bless the Lord with me. Come on, everybody say, bless the Lord. Clap your hands if you love Jesus. Clap your hands if you love the Lord. Say, clap your hands if you love Jesus. Clap your hands if you love the Lord. Say, come on, give him praise. Come on, give him praise. Come on, give him praise. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on and lift his name today.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
His name is worthy to be praised.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. Come on, one more time. Let's go to Alice right quick. Hey, clap your hands if you love Jesus. Clap your hands if you love the Lord. Say, clap your hands. Clap your hands if you love the Lord. Say, come on, give him praise. Come on, give him praise. Come on, give him praise. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on and praise his name.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, the highest praise. Oh, hallelujah. Come on, wherever you are, lift your hands, clap your hands. That is the highest praise. Hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. Come on, wherever you are, shout it out. Hallelujah. Come on, give God the highest praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, he's worthy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord God, we magnify you. We lift you up. God, you are so worthy to be praised. Come on, isn't he worthy to be praised? Come on, in such a time like this, we're still able to give God praise. God, you deserve all the praise. You deserve all the glory. You deserve all the honor. God, come on, lift your hands wherever you are. Just tell God, you deserve it. Come on. Come on, let him know you deserve it. All of it, God. Not some of the praise. All of the praise belongs to you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
You deserve it.
Oh, you got it now. I dare you to sing along with us. Open your hearts right now. My hallelujah.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Come on, wherever you are, in your car, in your home, on your job. My hallelujah.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
My hallelujah.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Everybody on one accord, you deserve it.
You deserve it.
Come on, bless his name.
You deserve it.
Lift up your voice and say, you deserve it.
You deserve it.
God, you're worthy. God, you're worthy.
You deserve it.
Lift your hands, come on.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Hey God.
My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you.
Come on and give him praise. Come on, I dare you right now to give him praise. Come on, if your hallelujah belongs to him, I dare you to give him praise. Come on, I don't know about you, but I got a reason to praise him. Come on, I don't know about you, but we all should have a reason to praise him. If you're able to hear, see, or listen to this broadcast right now, you got a reason to praise him. Come on, come on, come on. If you got shelter over your head right now, you got a reason to praise him. Hallelujah. Come on, give God praise. He deserves it. Come on, he deserves it. He deserves it. Hallelujah. All the honor, all the glory, it belongs to you, God. And we lift your name. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on and give God praise. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. Come on, we got a reason to praise him. Hallelujah. Come on, we got a reason to lift him up right now. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah, hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, God, hallelujah. Oh God, we praise you. God, we lift you up and we magnify you. Hallelujah, Jesus, hallelujah.
Yes, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. You know hallelujah is the highest praise. Hallelujah, it's the highest praise. It's the highest praise. When you say hallelujah, you're saying the highest praise to God. You got to give God praise this morning. Hallelujah. God, we thank you right now. We give you praise. We lift you up. Lord, we magnify your name. We glorify you, Lord God. God, we thank you right now. If we had 10,000 tongues, God, it wouldn't be enough. We're going to continue to say hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise begin praise. If you're not shouting right now, wherever you are, hallelujah. Oh my God. You don't have to be in the physical building to get that worship. Amen. You could be shouting right now, breaking yokes right now in your house. The word is already going forth right now. Praise is going forth right now. Healing is going forth right now. You need to reach up and pull it down and grab it right now. You need to grab it right now. You need to grab your breakthrough. Grab your praise. Grab your glory. Grab it right now. I dare you to reach down and start pulling down strongholds right now. Pull it down right now. Take it down right now. Pull down your blessing. Pull down your overflow. Pull down your healing. Pull down your breakthrough. Amen. Hallelujah. Right now. We're not waiting on a stimulus package because we got it right now. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All the glory. All the honor. All the praise right now. Hallelujah. My hallelujah. I don't know about yours, but Chantel, my hallelujah belongs to you, Lord God. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Pull it down right now. Pull it down right now. Walk over your home right now. Saturate your home right now. You're invoking atmosphere in your home right now with God. Invite God in right now. Pull it down right now. Yank it down. Walk around right now. Hallelujah. Woo! Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. Woo! Hallelujah. God, you're worthy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We glorify you, God. We magnify you, Lord God. We lift you up, God. We know if it wasn't nobody but you, Lord God, we wouldn't be here today, God. Through these times, God, only you could keep us in sound mind, body, and spirit. Amen. Hallelujah. Woo.
That's a praise, amen. Now that's a praise, amen. That's a praise right there, amen. Hallelujah. Woo. I feel the spirit is already saturated. We getting ready to receive a word from our bishop. He's going to take things to the next level to bless our soul with the word from God. After our song of preparation, we're going to hear none other than our bishop, Bishop Randy Lee Holtz.
Thank you. Shall we pray? Eternal God, our Father, we thank you again for this wonderful privilege, this awesome opportunity to be in your presence one more time. We thank you, God, for your power, your grace, your mercy. We thank you for your love that you have bestowed upon us. Thank you for how you have watched over us and how you have made ways for us. Thank you for your keeping power. Thank you for your love that surpasses all understanding. Today we come, God, not to ask for a whole lot of things, but we just come to tell you thank you. Thank you for being so good. Thank you for being so kind. Thank you for keeping us in the midst of this storm. Thank you for keeping our heads above water. Thank you for joy and strength, power, and a sound mind. We pray now, God, that you will release your anointing over this land. God, heal this land from this pandemic. Heal this land from the sin that has soaked the earth. We repent right now. This nation repent. The world repent, God. We honor you. We recognize you being the God of all. Have your way this morning. Visit every person wherever they may be, God, in their home, in the hospital, in the nursing home. Some are on the job working, trying to provide for their family. Some are out there, God, caring for the sick. Some are administering help for those who cannot help themselves. God, you know their name. You know where they are. Move by your spirit. Touch, heal, and deliver in the name of Jesus. Now, God, we ask your presence in this service today. Give power to your word. Give grace to those who will hear it. Give us an ear to hear. Give us a heart to receive. And give us a mind to do what your word will say. We thank you for these servants who are here today. God bless them right now. Strengthen them where they're weak. Build them where they've been torn. Prop them where they're leaning. And God bless them over and over again. We give your name glory today. We give your name honor. This is the day that you have made, and we're going to rejoice and be glad in it. Amen, amen, and amen. One more time, praise team. Come on. Blessed be the Lord. Thank you so much. God bless you. I want to thank God for this wonderful praise team, these servant leaders who are here today. Thank you, Alonzo. Thank you, Marianne. Thank you, Tina. To our musicians, I want to thank our minister of music, Minister Sigmund McGee, our percussionist, Jamal Bell. Thank you guys so much for being here today. Thanks to my daughter, Chantel, for facilitating and leading us in worship. And thanks to our able media staff who does such an awesome job. Karen and Colez and Sarah Lynn, thank you guys so much for your service and for your commitment to excellence. Charlene and I want to say to all of the New Hope family, we love you so much. To all of our friends and well-wishers across this land, we love you so much, and we thank you for being a part of this worship experience here this morning. Here at the New Hope Church, we believe in building strong families for the 21st century and beyond. And we will endeavor, even in this pandemic, we will endeavor to do the Lord's work and to carry out the Lord's will. Amen. While the world may be panicking, guess what? We're going to be praising. And while some may be walking in fear, we're going to be walking in faith. So that's our motto, and that's our stance in the Lord. And we're going to lift up our eyes to the hills, from whence cometh our help, because all of our help comes from the Lord who made the heavens and the earth. I'm going to request that you will share this message. If you're looking on Facebook now, just share it with your friends. Give comments, feedback to us. Let us know you're there. Amen. And we want to be responsive to you. Thank you for starting a watch party and sharing this with all of your friends and getting the word out. You are the evangelist this morning. You are getting the word out to those who need to hear a word from the Lord. Amen. This morning, I want to go right to the word. We have a rhema word for you. During this season that we're in, it is my commitment to you to give you a word that will encourage, that will empower you, that will build you up, and that will give you meaning, give you something to strive for. I want to make sure you have a rich word that will help you navigate through these troubled times. Amen. Now, the God we serve, he promised that he will never leave us nor forsake us, but he would be with us always, even to the end of the age. And we thank him this morning for never, ever breaking his promise. In the book of Psalms, Psalms 34, a familiar song to all of us, we're going to be looking at several verses from various translations again. I want to give you a flavor for the word so that you can see what God is saying to you. Psalms 34. And verse number one, Psalms 34 and verse number one. In the King James, it says, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. In the New English Translation, it reads, I will praise the Lord at all times. My mouth will continually praise him. How about that one? I will praise the Lord at all times. My mouth will continually, that word keeps coming up, will continually praise him. And the Message Bible says it this way, I bless God every chance I get. My lungs expand with his praise. I will bless God every chance I get. My lungs expand with his praise. Every time we inhale and exhale, we are praising God. Every time we inhale, and every time we exhale, we are praising God. This morning, I want to talk about this little old subject, praising our God. Praising our God. Now, David is the writer of this particular song. And David was a man after God's own heart. David understood the value of praise. Amen. David understood the value of praise. Now, David wasn't perfect, but David was a man after God's own heart. David wasn't perfect. David had failures. David lived in his flesh. And David did not do everything that he wanted to do, but he always had a heart for God. And God said about David, he's a man after my own heart. And David, after all of his experiences in life, after all his encounters in life, he came up with this verse here, this opening verse to this powerful, powerful text that talks about praising God. He says, using a personal pronoun, he says, I will bless the Lord at all times. Now, there it is right there. If you get nothing else from this message today, I want you to have this resolution in your spirit. I want you to be convinced beyond a shadow of a doubt. If nobody else praise him, you got a right to give him praise. If nobody else lift his name, you got a right to give him praise. If no one else honor him or recognize who God is, you got a right to give God praise. Amen? Amen. And we want to give God a righteous praise. A righteous praise. A radical praise. A right now praise. And David says it this way again, and his testimony is my testimony as well, and hopefully it is yours. He says, I will. There it is. Underline that. First two words, I will. There are certain things that you got to will. There are certain things you've got to desire. There are certain things you just got to say, this is what I'm going to do. This is who I am, and this is what I'm all about. You see, I will do this. And the one thing I'm going to do, the one thing I'm going to do, the one thing I'm going to do, I'm going to give God praise. I will bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord. You got to know where your blessing's coming from. You got to recognize where your blessing's coming from. And when you bless God, you're simply telling God, thank you. Thank you for being so kind. Thank you for being so good. Thank you for being so meticulous with me. God, out of everybody in the world, you saw fit to bless little old me. And God, because of that, here it is. I can't forget. I won't forget. My aim, my desire is to bless the Lord our God. David says, I will bless the Lord, watch this, at all times. Underline the word all. I will bless the Lord at all times. Now see, it's easy to bless God when things are going well. It's easy to bless God when you're on top of the world. It's easy to bless God when all of your needs are met, when you have the desires of your heart. Watch this. When there is no pain in your body, when there is no trouble in your view, it is so easy to bless God. But David said it this way, he will bless God not only in the good times. He didn't say it like that. I'm not going to bless God only when things are going well with me. He didn't say that. David said it this way, I will bless the Lord, when, David? At all times. Now, there are going to be some times, here it is, there are going to be some times in your life when things are not going the way you think they ought to go. There are going to be some times in your life when you're not going to know how you're going to make ends meet. There are going to be times in your life when pain will rack your body and medicine won't do you no good. There are going to be times in your life when you're going to feel like that nobody understand or care about you. But David said it this way, it doesn't matter what time I'm in or what season I'm in, I have made up my mind that in whatever state I'm in whatever condition I'm in whatever situation I'm faced with, I will bless the Lord at all times. Now, I know, I hear you right now. Bishop, we're in a pandemic. It's a good time to praise God. Bishop, we can't go to church. That's a good time to bless God. Bishop, we are restricted. We can't fellowship. We can't go out. We can't have friends over like we used to. That's a good time to bless God. Why? Because God still woke you up this morning. God still started you on your way. You still have life, health, and strength. And if you don't have the strength that you used to have, you got some strength. And thank God for the little strength you got. So you got to learn how to bless God at all times. You see, not only when you want to bless him or when things are going well, but even when things go awry, you got to still give God glory. You got to give God glory. And David says, I will bless the Lord at all times. Now David gives a prime example of this, you know, when he was in Ziklag. You remember that story in Ziklag? And David was out, him and his men, and while they were out, the enemy came in and ravaged the camp, burnt everything, and stole all the people, all of their children, their wives. And when they got back, they looked around, they wept, they cried. And some of the men was ready to turn on David. But David didn't give up. What did David do? David turned to God. And he gave God praise. And he gave God glory. And because he gave God praise, God said, you shall recover all. And I want you to know today, hallelujah. I want you to know today, mark my words, I want you to know today that you're going to recover everything the cankerworm tried to destroy. We coming out better than what we went in. This too shall pass. When this pandemic is over, we shall come out stronger. And the reason we're going to come out stronger is because we have learned even in the midst of this how to give God praise. You got to bless God. You got to give God what's due to him. You got to give God glory. You got to give God honor. You got to give God praise. I will bless the Lord at all times, David says. I will bless the Lord at all times. And in no time will I not bless him, but at all times I will bless him. He says, his praise shall continually be in my mouth. Oh, my God. You got to watch what comes out of your mouth. You see, watch what comes out of your mouth, because you got to guard what comes out, because whatever you say, whatever you decree, and whatever you declare, that's what it's going to be. So you can't let stuff just come out unfiltered. You got to monitor and measure what you say. You see, you can't do like we used to do when we was coming up, say stuff and holler slippers. I didn't mean that. Yes, you did. You meant it because you wanted to say it and your mouth just helped you do it. But listen, out of the heart speaks the abundance. The mouth speaks the abundance of what's on the heart. What's in your heart, your mouth will decree. What's in your mouth, in your heart, your mouth will declare. So you got to watch what comes in your ear gate. You got to watch what comes in your space. You got to watch what you're feeding your spirit with. Amen. You can't let no anything or anybody just tell you what they want to say. You got to monitor and measure. You got to hear what God is saying. That's why you got to force feed sometime the word of God. Even when you don't want to hear it, you don't want to read it, you got to force feed yourself the word of God. And when it gets in you, it may not feel good going down, but when it get to where it needs to go, it'll become sweeter than honey in the honeycomb. It will bless you. It will bless you. And even in the midst of this pandemic, in the midst of trouble, when you get the word of God in you, you can stand flat-footed and you can say, I shall not be moved. You can stand flat-footed and you can say, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. But every word that comes against me, God will utterly destroy. You can stand flat-footed and say, I know my Redeemer lives. I know where my help comes from. I will hide under the shadow of his wing in the time of trouble. He's a present help. You got to know that in your heart. And if you know it in your heart, speak that with your mouth. You got to open your mouth and decree and declare what God is saying. So therefore, David said it this way. He said, I will bless the Lord at all times. Watch this. And his praise shall continually be in my mouth. That's what's in my mouth. Not words to destroy, not words to deceive, not words to tear down, but what comes out of my mouth is what's going to build up the kingdom. I want to build up the kingdom. I want to be a blessing to my God. I want to tell him thank you. I want to praise him. I want to tell him, God, even though it don't look like what it should look like, I'm going to keep saying what you have said until it turn out the way you said it will turn out. I know the best is yet to come. I know there are more blessings in store that eyes have not seen and ears have not heard. I know that my healing is on the way. I know my breakthrough is on the way. I know my miracle is on the way. Stand on it, decree it, declare it, and give God glory. I know, David says, his praise shall continually be in my mouth. The New English says it this way, I will praise the Lord at all times. My mouth will continually praise him. I need some praises in the house. I need some praises for my friends. I don't want to hear no sad commentary. You know, I don't want to hear how bad things are. You know they're bad. Yeah, it's bad, but it ain't going to be bad always. Trouble don't last always. There's a bright side somewhere. Amen. There's a silver lining. Sun is going to shine again. We're going to laugh again. We're going to rejoice again. We're going to serve again. We're going to worship together again. We're going to be stronger after this. His praise shall continually, nonstop, be in my mouth. And like the Message Bible says it this way, I will bless God at every chance I get. See, that means you don't have to wait to get the church to bless him. You can bless God right there in your living room, right now. Right now, right there where you are. You can bless God right there in between eating breakfast. You can bless God in between doing your chores. You can bless God right where you are. You don't have to wait to get the church to bless him. You can bless him right where you are. He said, every chance I get, I will bless God. He said, my lungs expand with his praise. My lungs expand with his praise. You know when your lungs expand? Your lungs expand when you inhale. Yeah. Every time I inhale, I'm breathing the breath God is blowing in me. I'm inhaling the air. I'm inhaling his blessings. So therefore, when his blessings comes in me, my lungs expand. And therefore, when I exhale, I just want to tell him, thank you. Amen. Thank you. And every time you bless him with a thank you, every time you bless God with a hallelujah, every time you bless him with a praise your name, he sends another blessing back your way. Your lungs expand again. I will bless the Lord at all times. He says, my mouth will continually praise him. Verse number two, he says, my soul makes its boast in the Lord. My soul make its boast in the Lord. I will boast in the Lord and let the oppressed hear and rejoice. Yeah, my soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. And the Message Bible says, I live and breathe God. I live and breathe God. If things aren't going well, hear this and be happy. I live and breathe God. The New Testament says, in him we live, we move, and we have our being. So since we are not dead and done, we can still give God praise. Amen. You may not run as fast as you used to run. You may not have that long stride like you used to have. But as long as you can put one foot in front of the other, as long as you can keep waking up in the morning, keep looking up, keep raising your hands, keep throwing back your head, that's enough reason to give God praise. My soul, David says, not only with my mouth praising, but my soul, my sanctified soul will make its boast in the Lord. See, my soul got a reason to praise him. You know why? Because my soul been saved. My soul been saved. God has saved my soul. My soul has been redeemed from the hands of the enemy. My soul has been preserved. My soul will go back to God. See, the devil may attack your body, but he can't touch your soul. That's what he said about Job. He told Job, told the devil, devil, you can touch his body, but don't touch his soul. His soul belongs to me, and my soul make its boast in the Lord. The humble and the downtrodden will hear it and rejoice. Those who submit to God will hear the testimonies, how good God is, and they will rejoice. In verse 3, I can't take much more of this today. I was going to go to verse 8, but I'm going to stop on verse 3. Verse number 3 says it this way, oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us lift up his name together. That's the Amplified. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us lift up his name together. Yeah, in the New English, it says, magnify the Lord with me. Let us praise his name together. My God, magnify the Lord with me. Let us, you see, there's more than me who recognize how good God has been. There's more than just me that know how good God has been to us. There's more than just me that God has made a way for and opened doors. Yeah, there's more than just me that God is moving on your behalf. So he says, oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. The message says, join me in spreading the news. Together, let's get the word out. That's what I wanted to say this morning to all of you. Join me in spreading the news. What news are we going to spread? We're going to tell the world that Jesus is still on the throne. We're going to tell the world that Jesus can still heal your body. We're going to tell the world that Jesus can still save sin sick souls. He sits high and he looks low. His eyes is on the sparrow, and I know he's watching over you and me. We're going to spread the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ, that he is able to do anything but fail. Can I get a witness? Oh, magnify the Lord with me. That means I need somebody
to help me to lift him up? Will you help me lift up Jesus? He said in the word, if I be lifted up from the earth, I will draw all men unto me. How do you lift up Jesus? You lift him up in praise. You lift him up in worship. You lift him up in service. Everywhere you go, you ought to lift up Jesus. Tell the world that he's still able. Tell the world he can still feed. Feed the hungry. Clothe the naked. Be a doctor in everybody's sick room. Tell the world he can still comfort. He can still keep. He's a way maker. He's a heart fixer. He's a mind regulator. Tell the world that he's still able to make a way out of no way. Oh, do you know him? I said, do you know him? Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. I wish I had somebody right there in your living room with joined hands and say, if I be lifted, I will draw all men unto me. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Ain't he all right? Say yeah. Say yeah. Say yeah. Say yeah.
Bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. That's what I want you to do. Starting right now, right where you are. You don't have to get to the house of God to bless his name. You can bless him right there where you are. And everywhere you go, every chance you get, amen, every chance you get, every time your lungs expand, every time you inhale and exhale, let the praises of God come out of your being. You are a witness. You are a testimony. You are a living witness. Your life is a living testimony that God is worthy to be praised. Come on, put your hands together right where you are and give him glory. Yeah. Father, we thank you. And Father, we praise you for this wonderful privilege to worship you and to give your name glory. We thank you, God. Every chance we get, we're going to tell the world how good you've been to us. We know you got this. We know you are handling this even now. Even though we can't see the end yet, we know, God, you've already made a way out of no way. Thank you for keeping us even in the midst of this pandemic. And God, we're going to continue to give your name praise every chance we get. Every chance we get. Every chance we get, we're going to tell the world that you got this. And everything is going to be all right. The doors of the church are open. Maybe somebody right there in your living room, in your home, in doubt, don't know him. But right now, you can get to know him. Right now, if you will confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God has raised Jesus from the dead, he will put a praise in your belly. And you will have a reason and a right to bless the God of all eternity. We offer Christ to you, oh my brother, oh my sister. For Christ, Jesus Christ to you. Have done as the Lord required, yet there is room. If Israel be lost, Jacob will not lose his reward. We are so grateful and we are so thankful for being here right now and for having this golden privilege, this opportunity to praise God. Amen. Prophetess, how you doing this morning? All right. Say good morning.
Good morning, everyone. God is so good. He's just awesome, and it's just good to be in the number just one more time. Bishop, thank you for that message. I will bless the Lord at all times. And I will bless him at all times. When I wake up, when I sit down, when I'm giving, I'm just going to bless the Lord. Because if it had not been for the Lord, none of us would be here today. So I'm going to bless him at all times. I'll bless him during this pandemic. Like I'm just going to bless him. Hallelujah. I bless him for life this morning. I bless him for health this morning. I bless him. I just bless the Lord. How many of y'all you out there are blessing the Lord? I will bless the Lord at all times. Not sometimes, because sometimes when we get mad at folks, we don't want to talk to them no more. We don't want to be around them no more. But not with God. We got to bless him at all times. When I'm going out, when I'm coming in, when we're up, when we're down, when things are going good, when they're not going good, I will bless the Lord. I feel like blessing the Lord this morning because he has been good to me, been good to my family. I will bless the Lord. There is none like him. He is the great I am. I am that I am. Whatever you need him to be, he say, I'm that. You need him to be a doctor, I'm a doctor. You need him to be a nurse, I'm a nurse. You need him to be a lawyer, I'm a lawyer. You need him to be a friend, he's a friend. So I will bless the Lord at all times. Not all time. That means continually. Hallelujah. Lifting him up. Being his presence. Thank you, Bishop, for that message this morning. It blessed my soul. It was a great word for such a time as this. Because a lot of people are depressed and don't know what to do. What to do when you don't know what to do? Look to the hills from which come your help. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord at all times. God got this. He got the whole world in his hand, and he got this. He got you. He got me in his hand. So I will lift him up. To God be the glory. Thank you, Bishop. We love you.
Thank you so much, Prophetess. Amen. All right. Thank you so much. Listen, just before we go to our communion service, we want to talk about the opportunity to sow seed this morning, and to all of the New Hope family that are listening, to all of our friends who are there. Amen. Thank you so much for your continued support of this ministry. Ministry could not happen without you sowing into this soil, to this season. You can give this morning by Cash App, NHMBC 1881. It's on the screen right now. You can go to our website, newhopembc.com, press the give or the donate button, and your seed will reach the house. You can also give by tithing online, or you can give by text giving. All the information there is on the screen. And you can also come by every day, Monday through Friday, between the hours of 9 and 1, and one of our staff members will be here to receive you and to pray with you and to receive your gifts. And you can mail it in. But we want to make sure you have an opportunity to sow your seed. Because every time you sow a seed, listen, God opens the windows of heaven and pour out blessings that you won't have room enough to receive. Thank you so much for being a valued member, a valued supporter of the New Hope Ministry. God bless you, and we thank you in advance for the seeds that you will sow, and we praise God in advance for the blessings he's releasing back in your direction. All right, today we're going to have Holy Communion, and our praise team is going to give us a song, a preparation for that. So while they're singing, get your kits ready, and we're going to have communion in just a moment. If you will access now your kits, the bread and the drink. Prayer, Charlene.
Heavenly Father, help us to look up to you in faith, trusting you with all our hearts and soul, that you will direct our path. Teach us that your help, your goodness, your understanding, and all your promises are for all of us. And grant us day by day to commune with you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen.
On that night in the upper room there in Jerusalem, after supper, Jesus took bread in his hand, raised it toward heaven, gave thanks. He broke it and said, "Take, eat, this is my body that shall be broken for you." And they all ate together. In like manner, he then took the cup, raised it toward heaven, gave thanks, and said, "This is my blood which is shed for many for the remission of sin, but I won't drink no more of this fruit of the vine with you until I drink it new in my Father's kingdom." And they all drank together. And after supper, they went to the Mount of Olives, and they sung a hymn. I want to thank you again for being a part of this worship service today, and we trust and pray that God have given you a word that will help you, empower you, inspire you in days to come. And don't you ever forget to give God praise and to bless him at all times. Every time your lungs expand, every time you exhale, give God praise every chance you get. I love that word. Every chance I get, I'm going to give God praise. Happy birthday to my daughter-in-law, Katrina Holtz. Happy birthday to you, celebrating today, and may God continue to bless you, enrich you, and lift you in all the ways of obedience. Don't forget that I believe early voting is starting, and we want you to be an active participant this year. This is a crucial year in all of the races and opportunities. Please let your voice be heard by exercising your right to vote. Amen. God keep you, and God bless you, and keep you is our prayer. We're getting ready to go back to school. Our kids are getting ready to go back to school. We are praying for our children. We are praying for our administrators. We are praying for our teachers. We are praying for the support staff. This is a crucial time. Listen, they need prayers. They need our support. And here at the New Hope Church, we always support our kids with book bags and preparations. And our pastor of our youth ministry, Pastor Sharia Isom, is requesting that all ministries support with your donations and supplies. You can turn them into the church office so that we can have them ready to give to our kids to help them on their way when the school system reengage. But prayer is in order. Amen? Amen. Amen. God has spoken. Let the church say amen. Thank you for joining us today. May the Lord bless you real good. Come on, praise team. Everybody, God has spoken.
God has spoken.
So let the church,
let the
whole church. Can I get a witness?
Let the
church
say amen.
To what his word say.
Let the church
to what his will is.
Amen.
God has spoken.
God has spoken.
So let the church,
let the church
say. It's your response.
Amen.
Whatever he says.
Amen.
From the healing of your body.
Amen.
To the raising of the dead.
Amen.
No matter how you're feeling.
Amen.
How your world is reeling.
Amen.
Battle on through the night.
Amen.
Cause we gon' win this fight. Cause your help is on the way.
Amen.
Why?
God has
spoken. Well, well, well.
Let the church.
Let the whole church.
Amen.
God bless you and God keep you. And may heaven smile on you. Father, we thank you now for what our eyes have seen, our ears have heard, our hearts have felt. We promise, God, to bless your name, to give you praise every chance we get. Every time our lungs expand, every time we exhale, we want to give your name the glory and the honor. Go with us now as we leave this place, but never your presence. This we ask in Jesus' name. Let the church say amen. Come on, one more time. Oh! Well, well, well.
Let the church.
Let the whole church. All of New Hope. All the deacons. All the deaconesses. All the mothers.
God is spoken.
Well, well, well.
Let the church.
Let the church say.
Amen.
Let the church say. Let the church say.
God is spoken.
Until next time, we'll see you tomorrow morning, 6 a.m., Breakthrough Prayer. God bless you.